the hotel in downtown Houston. And it's Saturday night, and we're here for Lucy and David's wedding. Yay. And we're all going out to the, what's it, the flying what?
Flying saucer.
Flying saucer. Wow.
Carl Vern Shoemaker III, better known as Scuffy.
And you were friends of Rick and Tara up in Portland, right? Vancouver.
And the Greater Northwest.
And that's my Aunt Isabel again. Luann Bask. Judy.
Jody.
Jody, you were also up in Vancouver.
Yes. Yeah, they're married.
Okay, fellas, introduce yourself.
Tara's good-looking brother.
And you come from, you're down here from?
We're snowbirds out of Florida.
We drove from Fort Myers.
We drove in from Fort Myers, Florida.
Oh, Fort Myers. Oh.
Yep. And it's a case of the blonde leading the blind.
Okay. Hi. This is Matt Sewell here.
You're what?
Rick Sperling.
Yeah. And you are?
Red.
And
Red Sewer, this is my wife, Linda.
Hi, Linda.
This is Fred.
Eric. This is Nikki, Brenda.
Yeah, we don't like
daughter, Nikki.
Where did you come in from?
Michigan.
Erie, Michigan.
Wow. Came a long ways. Have you seen the bride and the groom yet?
No.
We saw the bride yesterday.
I don't think they're going to show up. They better show up tomorrow.
Here we are at the reception. We don't know where Tara and Rick are.
Or the bride and the groom.
We don't know where the bride and the groom are. I hope they show up here pretty soon.
It's not the reception, it's the rehearsal.
Which brother are you?
I'm the second oldest.
Second oldest.
Jerry's the oldest. I'm the better looking of the two.
And you're the sailor. He sails all over the world.
Yeah.
Okay. Grace has done this once or twice.
Thank you.
first woman in marriage?
Her mother and father.
Please be seated. Okay, to celebrate the love between Lucy Jones and David Toups. No other cause for celebration brings so much hope to us as a wedding does. We see the future in our own lives as limitless. Our spirits are lifted, seeing a young couple on the eve of a lifelong journey together. Their paths and lives crossed 5 years ago when David and Lucy kissed for the first time. They grabbed hands and smiled, and their love has grown each day. Today, they join together their love as one. Remember that love comes from the inside. Radiate your love freely as the sun shines its light on us. Our lives are made possible by the light and warmth of the sun, and as your relationship is made possible by the love you radiate to each other. So every day when you wake up, you'll wake up to the brilliant light of the sun and approach each challenge with the blinding light in your heart, reminding your sweetheart, there's no part of you which is not of the stars. There's no part of you which is not of light and love and warmth. Now, David, take Lucy's hand. Do you, David, take this woman, Lucy, to be your wife, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, from this day forward, as long as you both shall live? And do you, Lucy, take this man, David, to be your husband, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, from this day forward, as long as you both shall live? Bring forth the rings. The ring is a symbol of eternity. Like your love, it has no beginning and no end. So you give these rings to each other as a reminder of your endless love for one another.
Thank you.
those favors there, right?
What?
Little gifts right there.
They're little favors. So there are little mirror frames.
What?
They're little frames with
oh.
the same. And I'm not sure what's in the boxes. We'll have to see.
Dirty Toups.
Appreciate you coming down here and sharing our real happy moment. Two families coming together in marriage. I know that Lucy and David, they met and became friends. After a while, became best friends. And then they decided to get married and become best friends for life. That's good. And we know that life is full of ups and downs, as those that are married or those that are getting married, and they'll find out that it's pretty tough, you know. The only thing, advice I could give, I don't know if they're going to listen to me now, they didn't, as they're when they're kids. The thing I'd have to offer is the most important thing that I learned to be successful is that the respect is very important between you two. And anybody you do business with, really, for that matter, respect is key to success, really. It's the key to the kingdom, really. You know, there'll be times when you disagree with religion, politics, using all the towels in the hotel room, you know, before you haven't even showered yet, you know. So, that's another story. I just like to... make a toast, you know, to Lucy and David, and all the best wishes to them, and I'm sure they'll be successful. Thank you very much.
Privilege it is to be serving as best man. I've known David most of my life, and I know how much he loves and cares for Lucy. Lucy and David, I wish you a continued wonderful life together, and may all your dreams and wishes come true. Everybody raise your glass. Cheers.
I guess I'm supposed to say something too. All right, well. Once again, we've all known David for most of our lives at this point, over half. I think that technically makes it most. And Lucy's dad talked about welcoming him into the family. And there's another family that David has besides Gertie and everybody. Like, it's our family, me and Gomer and Frank. Like, we're his brothers. And I wanted to welcome you into that family also.
Emma. Yeah, we did. Although we lived a life, Lucy did always have the upper hand on me. She was born first, she got the height, the better hair, and of course, those beautiful blue eyes. Although she may have been blessed with all the best inherited traits from her parents, I was blessed with an amazing older sister who has taught me so much about life. Like worrying about what others think of you is a waste of time. Be whoever you are, no matter who's looking, and stand behind your family, no matter what. But of course, she also taught me the real important things, like how to walk in high heels, how to volumize my hair. So not just me, but everyone there around how a couple should treat one another, with understanding, patience, respect, and above all else, love towards one another. Lucy couldn't have found a more wonderful person to be her partner. And although David may never get to teach me about beauty tips, I look forward to getting the big brother I've always wanted. Someone so kind, fun, and of course, one heck of a beer drinker. Congrats to both of you. I can't wait to see what the future holds. I love you both so much.
Thank you very much for coming. I know a lot of you came a very long way.